Hello, everybody, and welcome to this week's BBC Learning English Pronunciation Live with me, your host. It is Roy. Hello, how are you? Say hello, let me know how you're doing. Okay, so about an hour ago, I put out a little message to say, send me as many words as you possibly could for this week's BBC Learning English Pronunciation Live. And lots of you sent some really, really great words. Lots of you sent brilliant words that I will be pronouncing today. But don't worry, if you didn't manage to send any words, keep sending them through today's pronunciation live and keep saying hello. Let me know how you are and where you're watching from in the world. There we've got, hello, Thamvarad, hello. Hello, Arsalfo from Burkina Faso, or Hassan from Burkina Faso. My name is Roy, by the way. I'm Roy, nice to meet you. Hello, Cheryl. Hi, hello. I just saw somebody from Tuscany and it's disappeared, but hello to you in Tuscany. Wow, it's going so quickly. Saw from Myanmar, hello, how are you? We've got Aya from Jordan, hello. Nan, hello. Keep sending hello. Ah, Kozu, hello, Roy, from Japan. Hello in Japan, how are you? So, like I said, about an hour ago, I sent out a call for some words for you to send me, and lots of you sent me some brilliant words for me today. Now, before we get cracking, I just need to tell you a few things. Hello, welcome, of course. My name is Roy. Now, if you're listening to my accent is from the south of England. I live on an island. Just off the south coast. I've moved around a lot during my life, but my accent predominantly sounds from the south of England. Why am I telling you this? Why is my accent from the Isle of Wight? Why is that important? Well, it's because all over the UK, you will hear different accents, even in the team, in the BBC Learning English team. There's lots of different accents you'll hear, and sometimes words sound a little bit different, and that's fine because everybody has different accents. The second thing I need to say is make sure that you can hear me. If you can't hear me, you can't hear me pronounce the words, and that's crazy. So make sure you've either got headphones on, earphones in, or you go somewhere quiet. Don't watch me. Nobody wants to hear my voice in a library. Everybody's reading and there's me going, hello, welcome. So make sure that you can hear me and you're somewhere. If you're on a bus, earphones. And finally, I just need to tell you that this is a pronunciation class. So while I may dip in a little bit to the meanings of the words, this is predominantly all about pronunciation. And keep sending me your words. Now, before I move on to the first word, I'm just going to add today's challenge. And today's challenge is, which of these words related to construction do not have the stress on the first syllable? Which of these construction words do not have the stress on the first syllable? Now, I'm going to tell you the answer to this quiz at the end of today's lesson, which is in about 28 minutes. How exact is that? But make sure you keep this quiz question in mind, and I will tell you the answer at the end. Okay, so... Oh, Roger Perry says A. Very quickly. And Carl Cow says, hello. Well, I think it's a good time right now. Hello. And hello, Edison, I just saw very quickly. Where are you? There. From Malaysia. Hello. Okay, I think it's a good time now to move in to today's first words that were sent in. Now, Evgeny wanted to know drought and draft. So that first word, drought, is a period of time without water. So this is drought, out, drought. So it's got this out noise, like out, get out, get out, drought. The second word is a very weird looking word, but the way we pronounce it is draft, draft, draft. So you have drought and draft, draft. Again, it's like, and notice I say draft, that A sound has an R sort of sound, an R. This is interesting because where I'm from in the South, we commonly make A's sound a bit like R's. So let me give you an example. grass in the north would be pronounced grass in the south. I'm on the grass. Pass. Lots of different words like this. The A double S words usually have pass, grass, and things like that. So this is a very important thing. In the north, people say pass, grass. Pass, pass, grass, grass. There you go. That's what I mean about accents. So thank you very much for that interesting pair of words, Evgeny. Okay, the next one was from somebody, I couldn't read your name, I'm afraid, but it is haughtily, haughtily. So again, it's haughtily, haughtily, fastidious, fastidious, and ambiguous, ambiguous. Then we have genuine, 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 genuine. And finally, we have prestige. So we have haughtily, fastidious, ambiguous, genuine, and prestige. Thank you very much to the person who sent that word. Sorry, but your name was written in a script that I couldn't read, but I wanted to include your words. So thank you very much for sending those in. And Ezra wants to know, scaffolding, scaffolding. This is the metal stuff that we put on the side of the house, often when we're repairing it. Scaffolding and loosened, loosened, loosened. Scaffolding, loosened. Scaffolding, loosened. Thank you very much for those words, Ezra. And if you're joining me now, my name is Roy. And this is BBC Learning English Pronunciation Live with me, your host, Roy. I should have said it that way around. And if you're looking for free English classes, we do lives most days of the week here on YouTube and Facebook. There's things like grammar lives, pronunciation lives, vocabulary lives, and even a live quiz. So make sure you keep checking out. This week, there's only two lives because we are celebrating the Queen's Jubilee in the UK. But normally, there's more than two. But keep sending me the words you would like to hear. So Language Pro says run, ran. Run, 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 ran. So run is the present simple. Ran is the past simple. Keep sending me your words. It's going so quickly. Keep coming, keep sending me your words. There's lots of people saying here. Yeshuaz wants to know longed, 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 longed. Alex says, have you said YouTube as YouTube? Yes, I did. That's a great question, Alex. Okay, commonly the TU sound in English, not always, but commonly the English pronounce TU as ch, ch, chew, tube. So YouTube, YouTube, I understand it reads as YouTube, but actually it's difficult to say YouTube. It's like a YouTube. So we say YouTube, YouTube. In London, the Underground Railway system is commonly referred to as the tube. I'm vegetarian, but some people eat a fish called tuna, tuna sandwich, tuna, tube, and YouTube. There's quite a few words like this. I'm not sure it's a golden rule for every TU. I can't think of anything off of the top of my head, but great question. Yep, we're live on YouTube and Facebook. Saul wants to know sophisticated. It's a very sophisticated word. So that PH sound has a F sound, sophisticated. Say it with me. Make sure when you're practicing these words, you're saying these words, sophisticated. When I say it, sophisticated, say it with me. This is a pronunciation class. Make sure you say these words with me. Somebody here says, hello, Rob. I'm not Rob, I'm Roy, but hello. So many people confuse our names. Okay. There we go. That was a good question there. Andrea says tube versus tunnel. Yeah, you're absolutely right. Thank you for that word, because I was trying to think of an example. So like I said, it's not a golden rule, but quite commonly people will pronounce the TU as a ch, but not always. So just be very mindful. Tunnel is pronounced tunnel. So it's a t sound, tunnel. It's not channel. Tunnel. Very, very good. That's so fast. Angel wants to know physician. 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 Very good. And Esme says, hi, Roy from Morocco. Virtual hug. Virtual hug for you too as well. There you go. And Evgeny says, good afternoon, Roy. Evgeny, we've already done your word. Your word came first. Drought and draft came right at the start, if you're joining me now. Okay. El Karabach, okay, I will try and speak a little bit more slowly. But my name is Roy, by the way. I need to put my name up. But fantastic. Thank you very much for that. Now, Ezra also wanted to know about this word, these two words, where the stress exists. So the first word is supervisor. 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 It's on the first syllable. Supervisor. Supervisor. I always do this with my hand, like I do, like it's like I'm playing basketball. I don't know. Supervisor, like the ball is going off. Supervisor. So I make sure when I was learning my second language, which is Portuguese, I would always do this with my hand to make sure I remembered where to put the stress. Supervisor. The second word is supervisory. Supervisory. So you've got supervisor, first syllable, supervisory, third syllable. Thank you, Ezra. I hope that clears up that question. But thank you very much for sending your words. Keep sending your words. We are live here. I'm going to have a quick drink just to keep going. Brilliant. Thank you very much for that, Ezra. Let's move on to Sabari's words. Sabari wants to know ensnare, 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 clairvoyant, clairvoyant, and cul-de-sac, cul-de-sac. So you've got ensnare, clairvoyant, and cul-de-sac. Now, for any of you wondering what a cul-de-sac is, it's actually, in English, it's a type of road. Now, in French, I think it translates as bottom of the bag, or bottom of the bag, I think. But in English, it relates to a small road that comes off of another road that is surrounded by houses. So there are no other roads connected to it. It's like a residential road, a tiny residential road, very small. Thank you very much for sending in those words. And Shanks wants to know suggestion and prohibition. Suggestion, chun. Chun, it's got that ch sound again on the suggestion and prohibition. So that's a shun sound, suggestion, suggestion. So it's got this chun sound. Thank you very much, Shanks, for sending in that word. Oh, those words, there's two. I'm an English teacher, not a maths teacher. I can't count, apparently. Okay, thank you, Shanks. Sharanya, I apologize if I got your name wrong there. My first apology for names. I apologize all through. You said power, flower, shower. You said power, flower, and words like this. So you've got power, flower, shower. Now, quite commonly, this noise, this O-W-E-R, is hour, hour, power, flower, shower. Not always, because English is a confusing language at times. We also have M-O-W-E-R, which is pronounced mower. Who knows why? But power, flower, shower, and mower, which is an interesting, interesting word. And if you are joining me now, hello and welcome to this week's BBC Learning English Pronunciation Live with me, your host. In my office, down on the Isle of Wight, it's Roy. Hello. And about an hour ago, I sent a bunch of words. I sent some words out. I asked you to send me words, and lots of you sent me great words. But keep sending them throughout today's show. And I'm going to dip into the comments in a moment. But I will just say, Do check out our website, bbclearningenglish.com. It's filled with lots of activities. There's quizzes. There are audios. There's lots of different things. And the best part about it is the website, it's completely free. All of the things you found there are completely free. So if you like free English classes, where your place. Okay, and I'm just going to bring up today's quiz question. It was this. The challenge was, which of these words do not have the stress on the first syllables? Which of these words do not have the stress on the first syllable? Keep those answers coming, and I'm going to go into the comments. Now, Pretty Girl wants to know, cushion, window, I think that's widow, clothes. Is that meant to be cushion? C-H-S. C-U-S-H-I-O-N, cushion, I think, widow and clothes. Repertoire, says Tanushree. Repertoire. Please utter repertoire. Repertoire. This is a word I absolutely, absolutely enjoy. Repertoire. It's not in my repertoire, which is like my list of skills and blah, blah, blah. It's not in my catalogue, my repertoire. It's not in my repertoire. Trois. It's got this trois sound. Okay, thank you very much for that. MD wants to know, how can I pronounce important? Important. Important. Exactly like that. Important. Say it with me, MD. Say it with me. Important. Important. Ah, thank you very much for that, MD. Tapua wants to know, I'm going to bring this big, but wants to know the pronunciation of this word, vegetable. Vegetable. It looks like veggie table. It is not veggie table. It's vegetable. 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 Three syllables. Vegetable. Vegetable. Thank you very much for that, Tapua. And Morton Raya wants to know, Lord and Load. Lord is a title. Lord and Load. Brilliant. And remember, this is today's challenge. Tell me which of these words do not have the syllable, stress on the first syllable. Tell me that, and I'll tell you at the end of today's lesson. Ah, a single ching wants to know, walk, work. Walk, work. So we have walk. W-A-L-K has got this walk, walk, walk. And the second word is work, so it's were. And it's strange because it looks like the second word should be pronounced like the first. So it's walk, dip on your feet, and it's work. Hopefully you understand my dippy-dippy-dippy. Walk, work, walk, work. Brilliant. Thank you very much for that. Oh. Kizzy says it's your first time. Welcome to your first time with me, Pronunciation Live. It's me, your teacher, Roy. Okay. Cesar wants to know, bear. Bear, which is like a, it's the animal, if you understood that. It's the animal, bear. So the first word, B-E-A-R, is bear. This is a beard, B-E-A-R-D, beard. Bear, beard. So the sound changes, it's bear, beard. And the last one is beer. So beard and beer. Like the last two words, beard is just with the D, and beer is like without the D. So you've got bear, beard, beer. Brilliant. Garments wants to know revolution. Revolution. Thank you very much for that word. And thank you very much, Cesar. I forgot to say thank you. Quang says hello from Vietnam. Hello, Quang. Patricia's saying hello. Lots of hellos. Yes, lots. I've just seen this. Usually says lots of people here. Yeah, we're very popular today. Very popular. Thank you very much for joining me. Erkan wants to know, explain. Can you explain this? I will explain. An explanation. Explain, explanation, explanation, explanation. Thank you very much, Erkan. Jesse wants to know, through, thought, and tough. So three words there that look very, very similar, and they are completely different pronunciations. The first one is you go through a forest from one side to another, through. And let's draw on that TH sound, through, through. So the final sound is ooh, but the start is through, through. So you've got this, and to make this sound, the best way I can describe making this sound is that we put our tongue on our teeth and blow air through. So it's an unvoiced sound, this sound. The TH has different pronunciations. The common ones is the common ones are through, and the same in thought. So you've got through and thought. And we also have the TH sound in words like though, which would be T-H-O-U-G-H. So you have the sound. It's like air blowing through your teeth. And you have the V. It's like a vibration. So the best way I could describe it, if you're making the unvoiced sound, like in through and thought, excuse me a second, I need to drink. It's thirsty work. We call it thirsty work. You have the th sound. It's like you're kind of, imagine you've got a birthday cake and you've got this, you're blowing out the candles, or you're trying to make a sound like a snake. Okay, through. The other sound is the V sound. And imagine you're trying to make a sound like a fly. Though. But this last word is tough. So it's a through, ooh, thought, and tough. Jesse, brilliant. Thank you very much for those words. Right, I'm gonna dip back into some of the words people sent me before the class. Yin Yin wants to know door, doll. Door, I'm looking at a door. There's a door in front of me. Door, it's like a door. Shut the door, please. My son says this a lot. Actually, he says shut the door because he likes to watch TV on his own. Door, so we have this or sound, or door, and we have doll, doll. So the first word has a long, prolonged vowel sound, door. Second word is a doll. Very quick. Very, very quick. Thank you very much, Yin Yin. Hope that answers your question. Let's move on to Mahmoud wants to know world. World. Now, this word comes up a lot. Interestingly, years before I became a teacher, I would never have imagined this word because it's such a small word. But then I realized there's all the L's and the R's together. And when I became a teacher, a lot of people asked this question. So the pronunciation is were. Think about, break it down. If you struggle to pronounce any words, my suggestion to you would be to just kind of break it down a little bit. So just to kind of slow it down. World. World. World, world, world. So break the sound down. It's one syllable, but just slow it down. Because sometimes, I agree, when I was learning Portuguese, some of the words were tricky to pronounce because I wasn't used to making these sounds with my mouth. So we had. So what I did was you have to train the muscles in your mouth. So world. Thank you very much for that word, Mahmoud. And Mohammed wants to know hiatus. A hiatus is a short break. So maybe we're having a conversation and I'm just gonna take a short hiatus. That's a hiatus. Okay, there we go. Thank you very much for that word, Mohammed. And if you're joining me now, this is BBC Learning English Pronunciation Live. You can see my name. There it is. I never know because it's back to front. You can see my name is there. My name is Roy. I'm broadcasting live from the Isle of Wight in my office. And hello. Hello again, Kizzy. Hello. Yep, thank you very much. This is BBC Learning English Pronunciation Live. Now, about an hour ago, I sent you a list of words to ask you that you would like me to pronounce, and you did, but keep them coming. And just to let you know, we are all over social media. We are everywhere. We're on Facebook, we're on Instagram, we're on Twitter, we're on YouTube. Obviously, if you're watching on YouTube or Facebook, you know, you're like, Roy, I know, I'm watching you right now. But we're all over social media, and we're even on Viber. So make sure to check us out. And Amit wants to know, suggest. I hope that helps, Amit. Asme wants to know, please, components. And Maria wants to know, conscious and conscience. Conscious, conscience. Shahira wants to know, how can I speak fluently? Good question. It's best way I can say to you is to keep practicing. It's cliched, but it's true. Keep practicing. Like, for example, a good way to improve one's pronunciation, I find, is sometimes to get a set phrase and keep repeating it. Keep making sure it's correct. So, for example, a phrase that a friend of mine always taught in the classroom was, the fastest train only takes an hour and a half. The fastest train only takes an hour and a half. Keep saying things like this. Keep practicing. Find a fixed phrase. Find something, and also find friends that you can practice with. Like, if we're doing a pronunciation class, practice with us. Say the words. If I say a word like fluently, you could say it with me, and practice. It's the best advice I can give. It's standard advice, but it's true. It works. I learned with taxi drivers. The way I improved my Portuguese in Brazil was with taxi drivers. Taxi drivers are there to drive you around. Practice time. If you're not in England, Chahira, then I understand, but films and practice what they're saying. Thank you very much for that question. This wants to know, or Juliana wants to know, and what? Is this the end? Not quite. Thank you very much for that, Liz. And I think that's his Tuam, but I'm sorry if I got your name wrong. Stereotypical. Thank you for that word as well. Bice wants to know rhythm. So that's a th sound. We did this sound earlier. If you didn't see that, make sure you go back and watch it again. It is rhythm. Jairi, hopefully, sorry, is zookeepers. Hopefully I got that name, your name right as well. I apologize if I didn't. Jairui, sorry. Basant wants to know mature. Again, it's that ch sound, chur, mature. Thank you for that, Bassam. And Elena wants to know flamboyant. I'm a bit flamboyant. I'm a bit, you know, exaggerated. Flamboyant, brilliant. Okay, and this word, Tessa very quickly wants to know phlegm, flame. Yes, phlegm. So the PHL is like a phlegm sound, phlegm, horrible word, phlegm and flame. Brilliant. And very quickly, before we go on to today's challenge, I just wanted to do these words from Mahmoud. Is taught, thought, bold, bald, stuff. So we have teach, taught, thought. Again, that sound. So taught and thought have a similar sound. Bold is like brave. I'm so bold. Bald is kind of like me, losing hair. Stuff is like, this room is filled with stuff. It's absolutely filled with stuff. And staff are the people who work in a place. Thank you very much for those words, Mahmoud. And finally, Hazrat wants to know doubt. 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 Brilliant. Thank you very much. Now, at the start of today's lesson, make it bigger. At the start of today's lesson, I gave you a little challenge. And I said, which of these construction words do not have the stress on the first syllable? Which of them do not? Give me your answers. Keep them coming. Keep them coming. What do you think? I'm going to answer a few questions. Hanan wants to know schedule. Schedule. Thank you for that word. Goodness me. It's going so fast. So Martha says D does not. There might be more than one. Mako says C, D, E does not. Okay, we'll find out in a second. Lisbeth says manufacture. Kin says B. Lots of answers. Lots of different answers. Somebody here says, Alessandra said A and D. That's gone very quickly. Asim says A, E, and F. Well, there are lots of questions, so it's time for me to reveal the answer. The answers are... these words do not have the stress on the first syllable. Manufacture is on the fact. Manufacture is on the third syllable. Architecture. Architecture is on the first. Structure on the first. I keep doing this with my hand. I'm like conducting an orchestra. Development is on the second syllable. Assembly is on the second syllable. And fabricate is on the first. So, I can see here, Chiwali Prince Priscilla says A, D, and E. You've got that right. Well done. Alia says D. That's correct. Ashrafan says A. That's correct. Sina says the question is, so in these words, there are multiple syllables. Like, for example, my name, Roy, has one syllable. Manufacture has four syllables. And in English, we stress some of the syllables or one of the syllables. So we say manufacture. So I was asking, which is the stressed syllable? Karthika got it right. Brilliant. Very quickly there. Domin says, please help me pronounce archive. Archive. I hope that helps. Archive, thank you for that. Okay, well, that brings me to the end of today's pronunciation live class. With me, your host, it was Roy. Thank you very much for joining me today. It's been an absolute pleasure. Make sure to join us. I think we've got another class tomorrow. And of course, next week after the Jubilee, we'll be back to sort of more normal live schedule. Schedule is that word. But for me today, all it leaves me to say is thank you guys for joining me. It's been an absolute pleasure. Absolute love spending time with you guys. See you next time. And it was good to spend time with you. Ciao for now.